Hello YouTube. So I've been looking forward to making a review of this bass clarinet for some time now. This is a brand new Royal Polaris. Royal is a company, they're based just outside of Boston. Their bass clarinets come in two flavors. There's a high end called the Firebird, and this is their intermediate model, which is called the Polaris. They do not have a low end model. Both of their bass clarinets are wood with silver keys. The Firebird just has some other bells and whistles on it compared to this Polaris here. They're made in China. They have a special factory that does this. This is not one of those typical, you know, Chinese made instruments that everyone stamps their names on. Apparently, I'm told, take great pains to make sure that the quality is exactly the way that they want it before they ship it to you. Once they're made, they are brought over to the US where they are tweaked and maybe sometimes reassembled just to make sure they're in perfect shape, and then they are sent to you. And that's actually done right here in New York. So anyway, I'm really excited. I haven't played this instrument yet, so I'm looking forward to it. You're gonna hear it as I hear it. Let's get started. Now, the first thing I'd like to talk about is the case itself. You know I'm a stickler for good cases. If you don't have a good case, your bass clarinet is going to go out of adjustment really quickly if it's not held nice and firmly in the case itself. But also the case needs to be somewhat ergonomically cool, right? So does it have backpack straps? Does it have several handles? And does it have a music pouch? Yes, yes, and yes. Backpack straps on the back, a handle to carry it sideways, a handle to carry it from the top. It is fabric covered. And it's not hard, it's kind of squishy but firm, which means I don't think it has a hard piece of laminate inside, which means the case is going to be lighter. All right, so let's open it up and give a look inside. All right, so it is a nice firm foam inside here. It's blue velvet, and there are these two kind of felt blankety things that sit in on top of the instrument. I don't know if these are just to cushion it some more or to create some more pressure to make sure that it doesn't jiggle. Whatever the case is, they seem pretty cool. Let's take a look to see how well it sits in the case and doesn't move top to bottom and left to right. Top joint's pretty good. Bottom joint is pretty solid. Left to right, yeah, it moves, but I don't think that's going to happen, especially if this is on there. There's a space for the neck. There's a space for a mouthpiece, which it doesn't come with, and of course the bell. One thing I'm noticing here is that it has two pegs. It has a short sitting peg and has a long standing peg. This is the first bass clarinet I've actually ever seen that comes standard with a standing peg. That's pretty badass. As I take it out, I notice that there is an end cap here, and the reason that that's there is so that the case itself can press against something that's not a key or that's not related to keys to keep the lower joint stable. And as you notice, when I jiggled it, it didn't move at all. I think it has to do with this end cap that's in there. One thing I want to point out about the top joint here, this is the top of it, is that the top tenon does not have a metal ring around it. I can't tell if this is wood, Delrin, or some other kind of polymer, but it is not a metal socket. And cosmetically, it looks pretty cool. So let's put it together. And as I look at it, it looks to be reminiscent of, to be honest with you, I'm just gonna call it like I see it. It looks to be a copy of the Buffet 1193 bass clarinet. And yeah, as I look at the bell here, there's a little vent right below the low C key. It's another one of those telltale signs that that it's based on an 1193. So as I mentioned, this Polaris is made out of African blackwood, granadilla wood. They source their wood from a lot of the same places that the rest of the bass clarinet manufacturers source their wood from. There aren't that many places left that make this kind of wood. So I understand that the company has a stockpile of it and they're making these instruments out of it. The keys are silver plated. There are the usual pads and bumpers and adjustment screws. The adjustment screws on this are metal and not Teflon, which means that there may be some tendencies for them to unscrew themselves. So you may need to watch that or put some Loctite on there or have your repair person put Loctite on it to make sure that it doesn't unadjust itself. But what's nice about it is that just about every key I see here has an adjustment screw. So that's cool. First impressions of the keys are that they are solid. These do not feel like student model bass clarinet keys. They don't wiggle very much. There's a little clanking in there. I think that can be worked on. I was told that this was not worked on and it came directly from the factory to me. So I'm gonna trust that, these kinds of small clanky noises are gonna get worked out before they get to you. Yeah, that low C, That's totally a Buffet 1193 right there. That bell tone that you hear is something that you don't hear in a Selmer bass clarinet. You hear them in bass clarinets that have a vent in the bell. Here, let me play this next to my Selmer. You can totally hear the difference, right? It feels very even. I love the tone. That's loud. Let's hear what it sounds like quietly. Yeah, so again, I hate to keep drawing comparisons to the Buffet, but it has the same problems that a Buffet has too, which is that the E and the F are just a hair stuffy and also a little bit more resistant. You can feel the difference in the air pressure needed to play those notes. That's with me making no adjustments to my air stream. So that can be overcome. Hundreds and thousands of bass clarinetists who play instruments like this overcome it every day, so don't worry about it. And now for the tuning moment of truth. For those of you who don't remember this app, you want to be looking at the third bar from your left, this one right here, and the whole goal is for this bar to stop moving. If it moves up, that means the note's sharp, and if it moves down, that means the note is flat. If it stops moving, the note is in tune. I'm going to play a chromatic scale from low C all the way to super high C. I've tuned it to A440. Let's give it a try. That's one of the best in-tune bass clarinets I've ever played. I'm not exaggerating. It is better in tune than my Selmer. Wow. It only has a few idiosyncrasies in terms of needing to play with a little bit more air pressure, like I was talking about, that E and that F and the F sharp in the clarion register. But man, oh man. You guys, it's clear that you spent a year figuring out the tuning for this thing, because this is the most in-tune bass clarinet I've ever seen. Oh my god. Next up, the playing test. I'm going to play the Polaris and my Selmer Ninja, which is a privilege. I may do the Selmer first, I may do the Polaris first, but I'm going to keep your eyes from deceiving you, or maybe they will deceive you, as you listen to these starting right now. Definitely could tell the difference. The first one I played was the Polaris, And the second one I played was the Selmer. I personally prefer the Selmer, no surprise. It blows more freely. It has a little bit more covered sound. It's more flexible in terms of the different timbres that it creates. I know that not from that piece, but from other pieces that I play. But the Polaris is a contender, okay? For those who don't want to spend an arm and a leg and just would prefer to spend a leg, the Polaris is actually a great instrument. It plays pretty consistently. It's amazingly in tune. I mean, we already talked about that. It does have a little bit of resistance that I find difficult to play through. But again, this instrument has never been adjusted. This instrument was just adjusted. So this instrument will only get better in terms of its ability to go over the break and note to note and have notes speak more easily than it does right now. Because like I said, it hasn't gone through any of that. All the pads, all the keys, none of that stuff has been tweaked at all. But that said, what I've heard from the manufacturers, they promise that every instrument will be professionally set up before it's sent to you. So that's good. Just wish they had professionally set it up before they sent it to me. But yeah, it is definitely an instrument to try if you're looking for something in that intermediate range of, let's say, $3,500 to $7,000. Royal, I gotta say thank you. You are the only manufacturer who makes an instrument in that intermediate price range. And it's not an intermediate instrument. It's actually kind of a professional instrument in terms of the wood quality, the key quality, the way it plays, the way it sounds, and the intonation. I am very, very impressed that you were able to pack all of that into an instrument that feels this good for just $6,800. So hats off to you. Now, the question that many of you are going to be asking is, where can I get my hands on this Polaris bass clarinet? And the answer is not many places, because Royal is a fairly new company. They're only a handful of years old. And the only dealer that I personally know of is the New York Clarinet Workshop. They were the ones that sent this instrument to me. They have the Polaris in stock. They have the higher end Firebird model in stock. So check their website if you're interested, or give them a call and set yourself up with a trial of this instrument if you'd like to give it a shot. I personally think that it's worth being on your list, especially if you're looking to move up from a plastic-based clarinet or a student model-based clarinet, but you don't really want to spend over $10,000 for a professional highest-end bass clarinet like I have. I've been really looking forward to making a video about the Polaris. I've known it's been in development for quite some time, so this has been fun for me. Thank you all for watching. We'll see you next time. Take care.